Good morning, dear children, and welcome back. This session is for class 6th, subject social science, chapter number 8 of history, and the name of the chapter is India, Climate, Vegetation, and Wildlife. So here in this chapter, we are discussing climate, vegetation, and wildlife of India. As in lecture number 1 of this chapter that we have already completed, we have covered climate and wildlife of India. So today we are going to take this topic, vegetation, which was left in the previous lecture. So in this lecture we are going to discuss about the vegetation of India. It's going to be our lecture number 2 of this chapter 8, Geography. So let's see the topics that we are going to discuss in this lecture. The topics to be discussed are natural vegetation. In this topic, we'll take what is natural vegetation. And the next topic is types of vegetation in India. Here we'll discuss different types of vegetation found in different areas of India. As in previous lecture, we discussed there the different areas of India. They have the variety of climate, different areas, they are varied in climate. So because of that, the different type of vegetation that is grown in different parts of India. So here types of vegetation we'll discuss. Importance of forest. We know that the forest, the home of wildlife, how these forests, or you can say the trees found there, they are important for us, that we are going to discuss in this part. And at last, there will be having questions for homework. Those will be on the basis of the topics we are going to cover. So listen very carefully so that you will be able to attempt the questions. Let's start the topics one by one. The first one is natural vegetation. From the name, we can easily define the vegetation that is grown naturally. Or how we define it, the plants like trees, shrubs, and grasses, which grow on their own without interference or help from human beings, are called natural vegetation. Means that plants, whether they are trees, shrubs, creepers, grasses, any type of plant, which grow on their own without any help of human being, means the plants, those grow naturally without without taking the help of any human being, that is the natural vegetation. Clear? How we define it? Now, due to varied climate conditions, India has a wide range of natural vegetation. As in the starting, I told you, we already discussed about the different climatic conditions that are in India. So, due to that varied climate conditions, India has the wide range of natural vegetation here. Now, we'll discuss about that different types of vegetation in India. Five different types of vegetation that is found there in India, in different parts of India. As different part, we already discussed that some areas, they are very hot, like the part of Rajasthan. Some areas are very cold. Some areas receive very high rainfall. So, according to the climatic conditions of a particular place, they are having a specific type of vegetation. So, the five main type of vegetations that we are going to discuss one by one now. And in that, we'll discuss the different plants, different trees found there in the specific type of vegetation. We'll also discuss some important points regarding that particular vegetation and the places where the particular type of vegetation is found. Like, first is tropical rainforest. They are found in the areas which receive heavy rainfall. Means the areas in India which receive very heavy rainfall, the tropical rainforest they are found. They are so dense that sunlight does not reach to the ground. Means they are, that its meaning is that sunlight that does not reach to the ground of these forest because they are so dense. The sunlight that remains there on the leaves only due to the dense quality of these forest, it does not reach to the ground. They shed their leaves at different times of the year. That's why they always appear green and are known as evergreen forest. This is very important point, that in these type of forest, the different trees those are found, they shed their leaves in different times. Means they all together, they do not shed their leaves. And that's why they remain green all the time. Because if one type of tree that shed the leaves, the others are green. The second that shed the leaves, the other trees, they are green. So they appear green all the time. And this is the reason that they are also known as evergreen forest, because every time they remain green, that's why they are famous as evergreen forest. Then important trees found here are mahogany, ebony and rosewood. They are hardwood trees basically. So this is very important part, that you must remember the example of trees in each and every type of vegetation. So here tropical rainforest, the important trees those are found are mahogany, ebony, rosewood, and they are basically the hardwood trees. Then they are found in the areas of Andaman and Nicobar Islands, parts of northeastern states. The part of northeastern states, if you remember, we had done about Meghalaya, that receive very heavy rainfall. So in that parts, that is there in northeastern state. So in that part, these type of plants they are found. In Andaman and Nicobar Island, these type of plants they are found. And along with this, northern eastern state and the narrow strip of western slope of Western Ghats. The Western Ghats that we discussed in previous chapter, so there also in these type of forest they are found. Now the next type, it is tropical deciduous forest. Second is tropical deciduous forest. These forests are found in large part of our country. Means most of the part they are covering this deciduous forest in India. These forests are less dense as the tropical rainforest we discussed now. They are very dense, but these tropical deciduous forests, they are less dense. Then they shed their leaves at a particular time of the year. That's why, as in the previous we discussed, they do not shed the leaves at a particular time. At different times they are living, but here what is given? They shed the leaves at a particular time of the year. So they face the autumn period there in these type of forest, when all the plants, all the trees, they shed their leaves all together. Then they are softwood trees, as tropical deciduous are softwood trees, and tropical rainforest they were the hardwood trees. Important trees found here are sal, neem, peepal and shisham. These, I think, all type of trees they are known to you, because in Haryana also these type of forests they are found. They are found in Madhya Pradesh, Uttar Pradesh, Bihar, Jharkhand, Orissa, etc. Clear? So in some of the part means these people, Shisham, Neem, these are found in our areas also, not everywhere, but in some of the places this deciduous type of trees they are also found here. So this is all about tropical deciduous forest. And one more thing, the tropical deciduous and tropical rainforest, these two type of forest, one more question that can be asked here, that differentiate between tropical rainforest and tropical deciduous forest. So on the basis of these points you can differentiate, like the first you can say these forests are less dense, but the rainforest they are so dense. Here they shed the leaves at particular time of the year. There you can write they shed their they do not shed the leaves at particular time of the year. They shed in different times. They are softwood trees, but those were the hardwood trees. Then example. So in this way, the 5 points you will make and you will write the difference. The next type it is the thorny bushes. Thorny bushes that we'll discuss here, in which areas they are found, and the what are the important trees here. This is found in the areas of less rainfall or in dry areas. These thorny bushes basically they are grown where the rainfall that the particular area receive very less rainfall, because these thorny bushes can survive in the in less water also. The leaves of these plants are in the form of spines, because these spines they reduce the loss of water there from the plants. So that's why they are already the scarcity of water that is present, less rainfall is there. So these leaves they are in the form of spines so that they can reduce the loss of water. Important trees found here are cactus, babool, kikar and khair. Here also kikar or babool, these type of plants are found here in our areas also. So thorny bushes are also present here. The areas now where they are found in the in Rajasthan, Punjab, Haryana, etc. So here in thorny bushes you can define them. If it is asked what are thorny bushes, so all the points you can write there. Then next it is mountain for vegetation. By the name easily we can identify that the vegetation that is grown on mountains, that is mountain vegetation. Now I'll discuss some points about it. This type of vegetation is found in mountains, that is clear. Then from the height of 1500 meter to 2500, here 2500 will come, 2500 meter, most of the trees are found in conical shape. They are known as coniferous trees. The plants, the trees, those are found in conical shape from 1500 to 2500 meters at the height of 1500 to 2500 meters. So they are in the shape of conical, and they are also known as coniferous trees. Important trees found here are chir, pine and devdar. These are the important trees found there in the mountain vegetation. Now the next or the last vegetation, that is mangrove forest. Mangrove forest basically grow in saline water, salty water you can say. These forests can survive in saline water. So they are mainly found in Sundarban in West Bengal and in the Andaman and Nicobar Islands. Sundarban, if you remember, we had done the delta formed by Ganga and Brahmaputra river, that is Sundarban delta. So the nearby that area, these type of forest they are found. So in Sundarban in West Bengal, and the another part in Andaman and Nicobar Islands also, these mangrove type of forest they are found. Now the main tree, here that is found, that is famous, important tree found here is Sundari. And that Sundari tree basically get the name on the basis of the area where it is grown, Sundarban. So that's why its name is Sundari tree. So important tree found here in mangrove forest, that is Sundari. Clear about all these five types of vegetation found in India? First, we had done tropical rainforest. Second, tropical deciduous forest. Third, the thorny bushes. Fifth, mountain vegetation. And fifth, mangrove forests. These are the five type of vegetation that is found there in India. Now, as we know that these forests, they are very important for us. Or you can say importance of plants, those are there in these forests. Clear? And due to the different needs or the development, the people, they are cutting down the trees. They are clearing the forest, and that is really very much harmful for the human being. So what should we do? If the cutting down of the trees that is done, so we should grow more and more trees. And even one of the example, it is given in your book also, one of the girl who always plant on her birthday. So you should also do that. So let's see how these plants are important. Plants release oxygen that we breathe and absorb CO2 that we exhale. We know that the human beings, they release CO2, and that is taken by plants. And the human beings, they inhale, or you can say they breathe oxygen, and that is exhaled by plant. So that is done. If the plants are less there, obviously the oxygen there will be less, and carbon dioxide that will increase, and that will really very much harmful for the human beings. So for making the balance there, we should grow more and more trees. The roots of the plants bind the soil that control the soil erosion. That also we know, we have done what is soil erosion, that is done by the different sources like wind, water, glaciers. When the upper layer of the earth that is cut down through these sources, and in when that upper layer that is cut down, obviously the nutrients or the fertility that is present in the soil that has been destroyed. So these plants basically they bind the soil and they control the soil erosion. Forest provide us timber for furniture. Medicinal plants provide us medicine like neem, tulsi, honey, gum. So these different items that we get from the plants, that's why also they are important. Forests are natural habitat of wildlife. The wildlife that we discussed in previous lecture, for the wildlife, for different animals, insects, different amphibians, mammals, these forests are home for that wildlife. So that's why to protect the wildlife, we should protect these forests also. So this is all about the importance of plants. Now, I hope that all the points that we have discussed, you have understood all those. Now it's time for homework. The questions that you are going to attempt are, do the following questions. Number one, what is natural vegetation? That we discussed, the complete definition you'll write here. Then, name the different types of vegetation found in India and also write two examples of trees found in each. Means, here what you do, you will write the name of vegetation, like if you have written tropical rainforest, you will write two examples of trees also, those are found. Like mahogany, ebony, rosewood, any two you can write here. Then you will take the next, that is tropical deciduous. You will write the example there, sal, neem. Then thorny bushes will take. Likewise, you will complete this question. Number three, what is the difference between evergreen forest and deciduous forest? So evergreen here means the tropical rainforest that we discussed, that they are also known as evergreen forest. Clear? And please mark the question mark at the last, that is missing here. Then fourth question, why is tropical rainforest also called evergreen forest? Again, then number 5, do question number 2 and 3 of book exercise in book itself. In exercise, question number 2 and 3, they are given. So you will complete these two questions that are in the book only, because the second is tick the correct answer and third is fill in the blanks. So this is the homework. Now it's time for homework solution of lecture 1. Question 1 it was, which wind bring rainfall in India? Why is it so important? Most of the rain is brought by monsoon winds in India. They are important because agriculture in India is dependent on this rain. Number 2, good monsoon means good rain and a large quantity of the crop. So that's why this monsoon wind, they are important. Second question it was, name the different seasons in India. Number 1, cold weather or winter season from December to February. Number 2, hot weather season or summer season from March to May. This month also you'll write. Number 3, it is southwest monsoon season or rainy season. It is June to September, J-U-N-E, June to September. Then season of retreating monsoon or autumn, October to November. So these four type of main you can say seasons you will write here, along with the period, time period, the months you will write here. Question number 3 it was, describe the wildlife in India. Answer, the wildlife in India, number 1, tiger is our national animal and found in various parts of our country. Number 2, Gir forest in Gujarat is home of Asiatic lion or lions, you can write. Camel and wild asses are found in the Great Indian Desert. Wild goats and snow leopard bears, they are found in the Himalayan region. Number 5, peacock is our national bird, but along with this peacock, different other birds are also found, like parrot, pigeon, bulbul, ducks, etc. They are in India. So this, the complete wildlife you will explain here, what type of animals and the birds they are found here. If the question is, describe the wildlife of India. Next is question 4. What is being done in India to preserve wildlife? Means, what steps have been taken for protecting the wildlife? Steps taken to preserve wildlife in India are, hunting and poaching of wild animals have been banned. Number 2, national parks, bird sanctuaries, biospheres have been set up to protect wildlife. Programs like Project Tiger and Project Elephant have been started. We observe or we celebrate Wildlife Week in the first week of October to create awareness among the people about the wildlife. And we are well maintaining the existence of reserves. Whatever we are, the programming we are having, we are well maintaining them. So this is all about the homework solution of lecture number 1. With this, the chapter is completed. Revise the chapter for the test. 7th chapter as well as this 8th chapter of geography. Thank you and have a nice day.